Maybe you already know that TV interviews, like those on The Tonight Show with Jimmy Fallon and The Ellen Show, are an absolutely fantastic way to learn real-life English. You hear unscripted, informal English spoken at a natural speed and with the vocabulary, expressions, and slang natives really use. Today, you will learn English with a funny interview with Daniel Radcliffe, who played Harry Potter in the famous movie series. This video is great because Daniel and Jimmy look at some different memes. Memes are comical photos that often include some sort of joke, which usually are very difficult for English learners to comprehend. So today, we will help you understand all of the jokes. Plus, you will learn all sorts of slang and informal language, and you will even see how natives creatively make grammatical errors. Not even natives speak perfectly, right? If you're new here, first you will watch a clip with subtitles, then you will learn all of the most important vocabulary, pronunciation, and cultural context before moving on to the next clip. Finally, you will test everything you learned by watching the full scene without subtitles and answering some quiz questions. Are you ready for a hilarious and fun English lesson? Then let's jump into this interview with Daniel Radcliffe. So unfortunately, YouTube would not allow us to upload the full interview. However, we still have it available for you to watch. We recommend you click the link at the top or in the description to watch the interview with subtitles. Come back to this video to learn all of the most important vocabulary, pronunciation, and understand all the jokes. Watch the interview a final time without subtitles and answer the quiz questions to test everything you learned. Alright, so hit pause now, go watch the interview, and we'll start the lesson in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
I was wondering if you ever see...
If you wonder about something, you think about it and you ask yourself about it.
I think my boyfriend's ever so dreamy. I wonder what our wedding's gonna be like.
Oftentimes, we use it before making a request.
Terry, I know that I haven't worked here very long, but I was wondering, do you think it would be possible if I got a $100 advance on my salary?
Another use of this word is the phrase no wonder, which means it is not surprising. We say this when a cause explains a consequence. Example. No wonder he's always tired in the morning. He never goes to bed earlier than 4 a.m.
Ever see, I know you're, if you go on the internet or anything, you ever see a meme of yourself?
If you understand the present perfect, you're probably familiar with the use of ever in this tense. For example, have you ever eaten sushi? What few learners are familiar with is the use of ever in the present simple, as used here by Jimmy. Ever here means at any time. So he's basically asking, do you, at any time, see a meme of yourself? Let's see other examples of ever in the present simple.
Do you ever, think about the future?
Sure I do.
Yeah? Am I in it?
Honey, you are it.
Hey, you know what? If you ever want to talk to me about a problem in your life with a guy, then I'd be fine with that.
So we're almost to 1 million subscribers, and to celebrate it, we have something big coming. But first, we need your feedback, and that's why right now we have a contest happening. So you could win our 48-week premium course, Fluent with Friends, which will help you learn to confidently understand natives and improve your fluency. Every single week, you get a 20-plus page PDF power lesson, vocabulary memorization software, exclusive videos you will not find on YouTube, and so much more. Plus, you get to join our Fluency Circle global community. All you have to do is give us your feedback by answering the 3 questions in this survey, and the 3 learners who have the best answers will win our Fluent with Friends Complete course, which normally costs $338, 100% free. Just click up here or down in the description below to share your story with us for your chance to win. And now let's get back to this hilarious interview with Daniel Radcliffe.
Or is that Harry Potter meme and you go like, that's pretty funny.
Of course, go is one of the most common verbs in English. However, a use that's not so accessible for learners is that in which it's used as an equivalent to say. Example, I was sitting there when a stranger comes up to me and goes, "Have we met before?" Sometimes I look back at when I was younger and go, "What was I thinking?" Know that this should only be used in an informal situation. If you have any doubt, you should just use say.
I think like maybe a couple over the years, but nothing that I can immediately remember. I don't seek them out.
Seek is a synonym of search or look for. In fact, this classic game you've probably played as a kid is called hide and seek in English. As a phrasal verb, when we say seek something out, it means we look for something until we find it. Example: he's a young professional who is using his English to seek out opportunities abroad. So Daniel here just means that he does not actively search for Harry Potter memes.
I feel like I should be educated.
Yeah.
If you're educated about something, someone gives you information about a particular subject or to show you a better way to do something. Example: the government is promoting a campaign to educate teenagers about drugs. We can use educating as an adjective.
Jay, Mom, how was class?
It was great. It was very educating, and now we know everything about the baby, no?
This guy here is a... this is Harry Pugger. I mean, it's...
Harry means having a lot of hair. As Daniel says,
great. It's
solid
cute.
Pun, cute dog.
Yeah,
it's great.
This is a pun or play on words. A pun is a humorous use of a word that has two meanings, or of words with the same sound but different meanings. The pun in this meme is that Harry and the name Harry sound the same. The breed of dog in this picture is a pug. So now that you know what both words mean, do you understand why this pun is funny?
We're starting off, you know.
I mean, that's what's not to like. That's great.
To start off means to begin something in a particular way.
We're going to start off nice and easy. You're going to see 10% thrust capacity at chief lift. And 3, 2, 1.
Seriously, just going to start off with 1% thrust capacity. And 3, 2, 1.
So every single week we help you learn English with TV series, movies, interviews, and more so that you can understand fast-speaking natives without getting lost, without missing the jokes, and without subtitles. Just like Angel, who says that in the 6 months that he's been subscribed to our channel, he has greatly improved his vocabulary, pronunciation, and speaking skills. And you can too. All you have to do is hit that subscribe button and the bell down below so you don't miss any of our new lessons.
If you're having Quidditch problems, I'll feel bad for you, son. I got 99 problems, but a snitch ain't one.
To understand this meme, you have to know where the 99 problems saying comes from. This is a popular song by rapper Jay-Z.
That's why they stay with me. So if you're having girl problems, I'll feel bad for you, son. Got 99 problems and a bitch ain't one. Hit it.
In this song, he's basically saying that he's popular with women. However, be careful. The way he uses the word bitch here is a very disrespectful way to refer to women. This phrase has gone on to become a popular joke. So in the context of this Harry Potter meme, it says first,
if you're having Quidditch problems, I'll feel bad for you, son.
Quidditch is of course the popular sport played in the wizarding world, which involves different types of flying objects and broomsticks. If you feel bad for someone, you empathize with a negative situation that they are experiencing. Finally, the way son is used here is a colloquial slang term, which would be used to refer to a friend. Keep in mind this use of it is very informal. Better alternatives are buddy, man, or mate.
If you're having Quidditch problems, I'll feel bad for you, son. I got 99 problems, but a snitch ain't one.
A snitch is one of the balls in Quidditch, and Harry Potter is a seeker whose job it is to find it. So do you now understand why this meme is funny? It makes Harry Potter sound like a gangster as he brags about not having problems with Quidditch as he is a talented seeker.
What's cool about that stuff is that like, I never like as a kid and you're just insecure and at that age.
Insecure is another way of saying that something is not safe. Example: are you sure we should drive this old car? It looks pretty insecure. However, the way that Daniel uses it here means that he did not feel sure about himself as a person. In other words, he was not confident. Example: she was feeling rather insecure when she went up to give her speech, but she ended up doing a fantastic job. it is very common to say that adolescents feel insecure about themselves.
I never felt cool at any point playing that character, and sort of these things go like, nah, people thought that was pretty cool.
It's yeah, like, it's of nice. Course.
In English, when we have a T between two vowel sounds, it often becomes what we call a tap T sound, which sounds very similar to a D or to the R sound in Latin languages like Spanish and Portuguese, among others. We can hear an example from earlier in the interview.
Or is that Harry Potter meme, and you go like, that's pretty funny. We're starting off, you know.
I mean, that's what's not.
While this is more common in American English, here Daniel gives us an example of where the tap T can appear even between two words, when one ends in a T and the next begins in a vowel.
And sort of these things go like, no.
Let's see some other examples.
I thought it was going to be a closed casket.
Can we just give that a chance?
And in this final example, because the next word begins with a D, the T and D just become one D sound.
I can't get to the copier. I'm thinking, what do I do? What do I do?
Hey, Harry Potter fan, be sure to check out all of our lessons with Harry Potter in this playlist by clicking up at the top or down in the description below.
It says, Ron, hold on. Are those shoes on sale? Ron, hold on!
We see two phrasal verbs here that mean the same thing. If we tell someone to hold on or hold up, we are simply telling them to wait. Example, hold on, let me finish this phone call and then I will help you. Hold up, wait for me.
I don't know, maybe teach acting. Sorry, hold on. Hello?
Okay, dig in.
Hold up.
As used in this meme, it would be said to interrupt someone in order to bring up something surprising that you have just noticed. This meme is simply making fun of Harry's shocked expression by making up a ridiculous dialogue like that he is surprised he just saw a sale on shoes.
Thinking about all them school loans, wondering if your wizardry degree is gonna work out. That's just...
Notice here that it appears that they are making a grammatical mistake in the way they use them. In reality, them is used informally in this way when speaking in a joking way about something. Example, if I keep going to the gym and eating right, I'm gonna get them muscles. Look, I got them tickets. Pack up, we're flying tomorrow. A loan is an amount of money that a person, business, or country borrows, especially from a bank.
Will you go to the hospital?
Dude, hernia operations cost like a lot, probably. Okay? Besides, it's getting darker and more painful. That means it's healing.
I will loan you the money. Just go to the hospital and let's just get that thing pushed back in.
Is Stuart trying to get a loan or find investors?
In the US, as university education is not free, many students are forced to take out loans in order to pay for their education. When we finish paying the money that has been given to us, we use the phrasal verb pay off, to pay off a loan.
I went to school for half my life. I have a doctorate. I'm still paying off college loans.
Well, how much do you owe? Maybe I can help you out.
This is a deep thought.
Like, you know what that actually is, though?
That you in deep thought?
A thought is, of course, an idea or opinion you have. A common collocation we use is deep thought, or to be in deep thought, which means to concentrate and think about something. This sense of deep is used together with many other words. It often means profound or intensely felt.
Hey, sweetie, come here, come sit down. Hey, Phoebe and I were just talking about how our relationship is deep and meaningful. It really is, don't you think?
Oh, totally.
Pull my finger.
I mean, you obviously have some deep feelings you're not confronting, and I think they're about your dad.
I don't want to talk about it, okay?
Why not?
All right, I hope that you understood all those jokes and memes the second time around, and remember that you could win our Fluent with Friends Complete course valued at $338. All you have to do is share your story with us by filling out this survey, and the three learners who have the best answers will win. And if you want to continue learning, be sure to check out one of these other videos that I know you're going to love. Now it's time to go beyond the classroom and live your English. Aw, yeah.